Welcome back to Gaming with Bigby. I am Bigby, and as you can see, we have returned to our UHC island. I actually spent a little bit of time off camera doing a few things, basically just getting settled, emptying my inventory. As a matter of fact, I got a few more things I need to get out of my inventory. And just doing a few things around the island. I did a little bit of leveling of the land out here, just a little bit. Took off a little of the space over in this area, kind of smoothed things out. I've actually increased the size of the little plateau that my house is on, because we need to build a smeltery, and in order to build the smeltery, we need a bigger building. I also did a little bit of expansion of my little farm down here, leveled off this little wedge-shaped piece of sand that was here, got rid of it, cleared it off. I've got the carrots planted here, we've got wheat in the middle, and then potatoes over there. So we're doing all right. There's still quite a lot more, quite a bit more to do. Filled in the spot where the gravel had been with sand, because I had lots of sand from leveling off that area there, which used to be at the level of where those trees in the background are. Lit things up around here, did a little bit more cow and chicken breeding, and that's about it. Didn't want to do too much off camera, because obviously the point of the series is for you to watch me surviving on the island and kind of, you know, let's playing this whole thing. But we are going to get back to doing what we're doing. Now, first thing we need to do before we get too much into worrying about the smelter is we need to expand the size of the house. House is not big enough. And we don't want the smeltery outside, and that's for a few reasons, actually. The first one being is, as you noticed when we were in the village, getting all of those, digging up all the smeltery blocks from the village, that the villagers were trapped inside of it. They would climb up into it and get trapped inside of it. Well, a large smeltery is dark on the inside, or can be dark on the inside. Especially if it doesn't have any metals in it, there's no ambient light. If it does have liquid metals in it, the liquid metals do let off ambient light enough to keep mobs from spawning. But if it's empty, it can get quite dark inside of a smeltery, which means mobs will spawn in there. They can also spawn along the top edge of the smeltery as well. So you know, that can, you know, it can cause you headaches. There are times when you might want mobs to spawn in the smeltery, particularly things like Endermen. If you're able to trap an Enderman into smeltery, although since they can transport almost anywhere they want, it's rather a very, very tall order to do that. But if you do manage to trap an Enderman in a smeltery and you melt them down, you get something called Liquid Ender, which is really cool and can be made into beacon blocks and other neat stuff like that. So you can make Ender Eyes out of it and stuff like that. So it's neat stuff, but very difficult to get that way. It's actually easier just to go straight up kill an Enderman and take his Ender Pearl and throw that in the smeltery and melt it down for Liquid Ender. Okay, I think I got all the trees here. Let's just collect up a few of the saplings. I don't really need apples right now. I got plenty. I don't really have enough gold to make another gold apple anyway. So, oh hey, look, I missed a piece of wood. Grab that. There we go. And we'll replant a few of these. Just kind of throw them up here. Real quick like. Okay, good enough. There, throw another one down. Gonna want to have those trees, so thankfully wood's a renewable resource in the real world and in Minecraft. It's a lot faster to renew it in Minecraft, that's for sure. At any rate, lots and lots and lots of wood. I don't need the logs, so we're just going to go ahead and turn it all into planks. And I need to expand my house. So I need to both go up and out. I don't really have enough cobble. So what I'm going to do, but I have plenty of wood. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to expand the footprint out as far as I can. I'm going to go out a little bit further here if I can. Do I have enough? Let's see. Well, I guess we'll find out, won't we? Oh, I've only got two left. Bonk. And bonk, got a little overhang on it. Okay, now we'll use some of those planks. And now it is, of course, more efficient to actually turn these into half slabs and just fill this whole area with half slabs, but laying down half slabs is a real pain in the keister. Pretty much, you know, I mean, if I was just doing this for my own, you know, just playing, I would absolutely do that. I would absolutely lay down half slabs and, you know, there'd be no question that's the way I would do it. But because I'm doing this on camera and I'm trying to be quick about it, we'll gear up that. I don't have any more cobble, so we're going to have to go grab some more cobble. Because I'm trying to be quick about it, just make sure it's lit up. I'm not going to bother making the half slabs. It's just so fiddly putting them down. It's kind of a pain in the neck, so I'm not going to bother. I hope you don't mind. Let's see. Let's just mine out a little bit more of this here. Let's go straight down this wall. Oh, and see, now we're reaching the end here, so that's some sandstone. So if I want to get more regular stone, I'm actually going to have to go down a level. So let's go ahead and do that. Don't need a whole ton of it. And yes, I do know that I could just burrow down and make a big mine or something, just clear out an area. And, you know, once I start, believe it or not, once we get the smeltery going, we're not going to be lacking for cobble. We're going to have cobble coming out of our ears because I'm going to make a mining hammer. And since the mining hammer mines 9 blocks at once in a 3x3 square, you can imagine how much cobble you get and how quickly you get it. It's a little ridiculous how fast you can get cobble. Just kind of mine this up real quick here. One layer should be more than enough. I hear zombies. Roar to you too. Alright, that should be fine. It's well lit, that's for sure. Didn't actually need to use that torch. Oh man, that must be like right underneath there. There's probably a little space under there or something just big enough to spawn mobs in. And because if you think about it, the land that I'm on is actually a tower. Because this just drops very, very straight down to the bottom of the deep ocean. So there really isn't very many places for mobs to spawn. So wherever they're going to spawn, they are really going to spawn. They're going to spawn in earnest and in very large amounts. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to tear out this wall. And we're going to extend... I'm going to have to break my glass. Okay, we'll just knock this whole wall down. Actually, I didn't want to take that block. Whoops. No. Oopsie. There we go. And I apologize if the building stuff isn't very exciting. I think what I might do here is I'm just going to go ahead and pause the timer. And I'm going to go ahead and kind of build up the rest of this house. And we'll just do it in accelerated mode. So we'll go ahead and do that in 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, and we're back. As you can see, I've not quite finished it, but I kind of ran out of wood, and I didn't really want to take any more time building on it right now. I'll finish up the roof off camera. But as you can see, we've got our expanded building here. I just decided to make it mostly out of glass. Yeah, a bit of an industrial look, but hey, what the heck. Alright, so we need to get started with the smeltery. First thing we need to do is we need this clay, and we're going to need some sand, and we're going to need some gravel. Now, unfortunately, we are rather short on gravel. We have a little bit of gravel, though, and it should be enough to get us started. So let's go ahead and get started here. First of all, we have to break these blocks back into clay balls, because we can't actually use... We can't actually use the blocks in the recipe. What we do is we take it over here and take the blocks and take that and take that, and that gives us a whole bunch of grout. And yes, I am grout. funny the jokes. Okay. So we're going to cook that grout up. In the meantime, we'll just go ahead and put the rest of that clay and that sand back in. Obviously, I blew a heart on getting clay that I didn't even need. I mean, we really only needed 2-3 stacks of that after we got all of this. Now, you'll notice I put the starter blocks for the smeltery right here. It's a little off-center, but that's okay. Doesn't have to be perfectly centered. But when we cook them, that gives us seared bricks. So we're going to let the seared bricks cook up. In the meantime, what we'll do is we will build up the rest of our smeltery structure. So we're going to need... Technically, we don't actually need the corner pieces. As a matter of fact, it sometimes makes it easier to get around this thing when you don't put the corner pieces in. But we're going to go ahead and we're going to build the basic structure of our smeltery. Some of these blocks that I'm putting here on the first level are going to come out once we have built the rest of the smeltery. As a matter of fact, before I go any further, I want to make sure I've got some sand with me, because I'm going to need that to get back down. Because this thing, with all the blocks we've got, this thing's going to be big. If you have the chance to make your smeltery really large, make your smeltery really large. Because the more space you've got in your smeltery, the more stuff you can fit into your smeltery. And this is about it. That's it. We're actually probably going to have more blocks than we can actually use. Let's very carefully walk over here. I'm not crouching. I don't know why. Let's use shift. I don't know why I wasn't shifting. That was kind of dumb. Oh. Oh. And we are out of blocks. Let's see. And this is where having sand comes in. Quick way down without hurting ourselves. But we have a whole bunch more blocks. Now how do I get back up there? Why? We just pillar back up with the sand, of course. So there we go. Yes, I know. Basic building techniques. Everybody who's been playing Minecraft for more than 5 minutes knows. But you know, every once in a while you find somebody who doesn't know about that. Gravel also works. The only problem with gravel is, as you may have seen during my building montage, using gravel occasionally means that you will you'll accidentally clip the you'll accidentally turn them you might accidentally turn your gravel into flint. Yeah, that's the words I'm looking for. Yes, I can talk. Yeah, so that's always something you have to be concerned about, is turning your gravel into flint by mistake. I'm going to open that up. Hey, there we go. Look. You know, I probably ought to have the stairs going the other way. In fact, I think I will. Let's see. As long as we're waiting for those seared bricks to cook up, let's go ahead and make our stairs look better. Oh, look at that. Whoops. Oh, no, that didn't work. There we go. And can I still get up? Yes, I can. Cool. That works much better. Not blocking as much of the window that way. Okay. So we've got, you'll notice I took two bricks out. And actually this brick's going to come out too. I just have to figure out what I'm going to do. I'm going to have to make some more, chests. Okay, that'll do for now. Alright, so let's go ahead and let's take that block out, because we want that. And we have our seared brick. Oh, you know what? I'm going to do with my coal. Or charcoal, as the case may be. Here we go. Alright, guys, so we got our seared bricks, and we're going to go over here, and we're going to make a smeltery controller, as it says in the subtitle, the brain of the smeltery, and that gives us the mighty smelting book. And we need... Did I use up all the glass? I did. So, where's the sand? There it is. We're gonna have to smelt up a little bit more glass. Oh, wait, no, I didn't. Never mind. Yeah, well, we'll go ahead and smelt up a little bit more. Alrighty, and now we need to make... Where are those? Smeltery drain. Nope, that's not right. And a seared tank, and another smeltery drain. And that is it for our time, but before we go, I am going to finish this, because I do want you guys to see what it looks like when it's done. So first we're going to put in, I'll put a smeltery drain up front, because that's just the way I like to do it. And then we'll put the seared tank over here. And then we will put in the smelter controller, and voila, we have a completed smeltery. And there's some other parts that we're going to have to put on this. In fact, we'll go ahead and make one of them right now, because we're just about out of seared bricks. The seared faucet. And I'm going to take this spot on the floor out, and we're going to put the seared faucet right there. And we're going to put a casting table down there, and we're going to need more, we're definitely going to need more, we're going to need more gravel, because we're going to have to make more sear bricks. But this is a fully functional smeltery. The only thing it's lacking is lava that goes in that tank right there. So we've got to work on getting some lava. We'll probably continue to spiral downwards until we get to lava level and just look for some lava down underground, because we didn't come across any in our wanderings and we don't have any here on our UHC islands. But here we are with our finished smeltery. And as we come to the end of this episode, we are standing in front of our smeltery, and I want to thank you very, very much for bearing with this long build process, and thank you for watching. And if you're enjoying this series, please do subscribe and give me a like. That really helps me out a lot. And I will see you in the next episode.